He called his nigga Skillet, but we gonna get the story.
Skillet,
Mahoney. Hey, what do you call me, Honey?
Huh?
What do y'all call me?
Khalid.
Nope. What else?
I can't remember.
You made that. You see these niggas too.
Kind
of pretty Ricky ass nigga.
Oh,
that's
pretty
what
Ricky. That's pretty Ricky. Ricky. Yep.
Boy, I don't know how the fuck these niggas forget.
Pretty motherfucking.
But yo,
you know what?
These motherfuckers right here, man. Today is my man's Irby fucking 77th birthday.
77.
That motherfucker up there with Joe Biden. Yo, we just gonna sit here and talk shit. Y'all gonna hear so much good shit that's gonna come out of our mouth. I mean, stories from 27 years because we haven't been in the same room since 98. Yeah, so we gonna start it off with the birthday boy. What's going on, James?
Man, listen, let me tell you something. First of all, hey, I appreciate you inviting me on your show.
My nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
My nigga. All
and,
man.
And then next off, I want to appreciate your cameraman because he finna get some laughs in.
Yeah, oh, man.
It's okay if
he already been cracking the fuck
exactly.
up.
Exactly.
So the then, pre-camera roll has been popping.
The next thing is, man, it's good to be in a room with some fellas that I've been knowing since 1995.
And these two niggas damn near boxed the first time they met.
Yep, true indeed. But this cat right here, man,
go way back by Four Flats, man.
But hold on. Before I get on this, man, I want to tell y'all some real shit. I was it 90? What was it? 96? We was in a room, and old Pretty Ricky over there had his girlfriend at the time.
Yeah, let's not say no names, nigga.
At Fort Drum.
I can't stand that bitch.
And
you know she listening to this shit.
I don't give a fuck. I hope she fucking envious in the motherfucker.
Nah, man.
And he said, hey, y'all shut up. I got something I got to do. And I'm like, oh, shit, what's going on? This man proposed to his first wife in front of me. I felt the privilege of that shit.
Facts.
And, we was like brothers. I was like his big brother.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we every time he
was nigga. You still is.
Still
is
like
my brother, brother.
Man, fuck you. But anyway,
I hate everything about this nigga right now.
But that was the love that this man he wanted. He shared with me. You know what I'm saying? I felt so privileged. And then we got this motherfucker right here. Yeah, I call him a motherfucker.
Hey, I am a motherfucker. Right I know I'm a motherfucker.
Like Jones said earlier, Pretty Ricky said earlier, me and the cleaner, we almost throw fisticuffs.
Hey, man.
Okay, so we're going to talk about each other's stories, right? I need you to tell us why this nigga name is the cleaner.
My man right here, it wasn't me who he cleaned first. It was somebody else. But he did get me.
We got to give him his credit for the one time with the roommate. Through the bathroom.
Oh!
Give him the story.
Oh.
I'll tell the motherfucking story. So, it was another motherfucker in the barracks who's kind of a pretty Ricky ass nigga.
Eric Davis.
Eric fucking Davis.
I'm gonna say his goddamn
fuck
name.
It don't matter. I hope he watching it. This motherfucker brought some broad to the barracks. I can't remember her name, but it was one of the bitches that he had already smashed.
Okay, I'm gonna tell the story, man. Because this story getting fucked up all over.
That's why I didn't want to tell it.
All right.
Fuck it.
So, when I first got the fucking drum, me and Keisha had a little thing going and shit. But then, you move on and all that stuff, man. So fucking Davis, who was my roommate, we shared a bathroom in the fucking barracks. So Davis was like, yo, man, I got this chick over here, man. And she said she know you. I'm like, so damn, why you dropping my goddamn name to some broad? I don't even know who you're talking about. And he was like, well, I'm just talking, man. She was asking me about who I know and all that stuff. And I was like, oh, okay, all right. So, and her name and shit, so I ain't paying no fucking mind. So later on that night, I went back to my room. I'm sitting in there chilling, you know, getting ready to go to the club. So I just got out of the shower or whatever. And I was just sitting there watching some TV and thinking to myself, damn, this is the one Davis was talking about. We sitting there on my bed and shit, man. The next thing you know, Keisha's telling me all kind of shit like, you know, I ain't seen you in a while and whatnot, blah, blah, blah. And this motherfucker, man, it's just something about, I don't know, man. This girl, man, she just do things to me, man. She's just to make me feel it some type of way. I'm going down memory lane. But
this is what old niggas do.
But shut the hell up.
Right there.
I know. So Keisha, she's sitting there. She tells me all the right things and shit. And so this motherfucker's like, hey.
Hey, your dick was in the mouth.
Yeah, man. They saying, no, man, this motherfucker done got me, bro. She done had me done pull it out, man. Well, hell, she pulled it out. And we started to do what we've been doing, man. They saying, I'm hitting that shit from the back. And here come Davis. I see the fucking light from a bathroom door open up and shit, man. I'm like, oh, shit. I'm hitting that shit from the back. And Davis like, I see him peep through the fucking side and shit looking. Because I know he heard the action going on. And that motherfucker was like, oh, shit. I heard him say that while I was still hitting it.
And oh, shit.
I didn't know that that was the girl that he was talking about he was hooking up with. Because he didn't say her name.
Yeah, that was on him.
That's how I got the name to cleaner and shit. But I tell you, and I knew he was still standing there while I was hitting it. So I hit that shit from like, paka! Bucking that motherfucker, man. And that motherfucker closed the door. I was like, yeah, I'm going to finish this shit off. Hey, that's how I got the name to cleaner.
That thing's crazy. But now, I'm going to tell you a story that you probably going to laugh at. You, especially you. You're going to laugh. So was it Governor?
No, Carthage.
Carthage. We was in Carthage, right?
I thought about that shit the other day.
I had a green altar. So green, blue, whatever it was.
It was like a greenish blue. It was
so
like a greenish blue.
We sitting in the car.
It was clean, though.
We sitting in the car. We smoking a blunt, man. We, without a blunt, a joint.
We mind you, we all been in the military for some years now.
Yes.
Not even that damn long.
It was about 3 years.
Not even three years yet.
So we killing this joint. Passing it back and forth. I got my sunroof open so the smoke can go up. Man, I'm in mid-puff. Motherfucking police.
Pulls up right beside us.
Me and Mo looking at each other like, oh,
and
shit.
And all I could say was, drive, nigga, drive!
So look. He said that. I cranked up. We roll off. We ride off. We could have been riding for about 5 minutes, but it felt like we was riding for an hour.
Yeah, and that nigga was going slow as fuck.
I was doing about 5 miles an hour. Now keep in mind, it's a stick shift. I still got the joint in my hand. And this muggle, Mo sitting over there like this.
I'm fucked up. I was time traveling. I ain't gonna lie.
Look, turn around.
What century is it, nigga?
Park, right? So when I parked, I said, man, let's go on in here. Because it was a bad snowstorm. So we thought we literally was stuck in Carthage.
Yeah.
So we go back in the house and Pam.
Pam.
So Pam had kids, mm-hmm. right? And they, to this day, these kids remember me.
The Jackson Five.
So we in the house, and they want Mahoney to read a book. And I said, no, I'll read the book. So I'm reading the book slow than a motherfucker. Mahoney and Pam over there dying laughing.
Bruh, I damn near pissed myself when this nigga started reading, look, bro, because this motherfucker.
I was so high.
Dr. Seuss ass nigga.
No. Dr. Seuss.
Hey, that shit was so funny, Joe. I had to run about the goddamn room, brother, stop myself from pissing myself.
So when I got done reading the story, the book to him, I got a phone call. It was a chick in Syracuse mm-hmm. that I messed with. Now the roads is closed. The roads are closed. Anyone is closed.
You know how it is when it blizzard up in fucking New York, man. I mean, they shut down every goddamn thing.
She said, I need to see you.
That nigga rolled.
On the way. Hour and a half later, I called Mahoney and Pam. Hey, I made it. Mahoney say, how the fuck you make the Syracuse?
In the time that he did make it to damn Syracuse. Because we all know Syracuse was like an hour drive from damn Trump.
Yeah.
But that motherfucker was pushing it. He made it in a goddamn hour in the goddamn snow. So hey, what the fuck?
Hey, got there, right? So boom, I get there. I call Mo. I say, hey, man, I made it, man. He said, what the fuck, man? I said, man, I ain't got time to talk right now. I got to handle some business. Hold the phone up. Now, let's go 15 years later.
Oh, shit.
No,
here we
20 years later.
Oh, goddamn.
I'm at Fort Hood. I'm in the club.
Get money.
I'm getting in. Getting money. I'm tapping the wife. Me wiping that. Dancing on the dance floor. What the fuck tapping me on the shoulder? I'm with the wife. I'm like tapping me on the shoulder. Look back. Oh, shit. It's Pam. So I introduced Pam to the wife. You know, Pam and the wife talk.
Okay, so this is Sergeant Major's wife.
Yeah, so I'm
okay.
Midwife.
Okay, so no, there was one of them before, but I just want to make sure I'm clear.
It was more than one before that.
Well, you know, I didn't want to open my man's case.
So,
up,
so,
you know
so,
mean?
So literally, you know, I introduced her and you know, boom, you know, everything said and done. Man, I left the wife in the club with the MC because she in the MC and I'm an MC.
Right.
I went outside. I called this man. I say, bro. He like, what's up, man? I said, you won't believe who here with me just tapped me on the shoulder. He's like, who? I said, Pam. He said, oh, I got to come visit you. This nigga never came. I told him. I said, I got a room for you. Come on. Come see me.
Hey, but hey, it was a little difficult for me at the time, man. You know,
I got you. But shit was going on. At the end of the day, no shit. Boom. So Pam, I said, Pam, tell your kids. I said, hey. And she said, okay. So she did. Well, her daughter, the oldest daughter, wanted to play ball. Who, you know, but her oldest daughter say, oh, I remember him. He read us that book. I remember him.
No.
Yes.
Stop her fucking
kids,
with me.
Her kids remember me.
Hey, yo. Peep game. We're going to come back right after this break. I'm going to give these cats a chance to go ahead and get a little liquor and go to the bathroom. We're going to come right back to you. Yo, welcome back to Autos with Al, your host, Mr. 3A. I got these dumb motherfuckers right here with me. These motherfuckers get on my nerves. I can't even fucking do my intro with these motherfuckers.
Your intro is gay.
Gay meaning?
Your mama is a punk bitch.
Okay, so they talking like Mad Dog, which is a first sergeant Maddox.
Hey, how did it feel to be back off the streets from being homeless? He got tired of sitting in the soup line.
Yo, no, seriously, we need to fucking find Mad Dog. Hey, we have to find this ball, man.
I don't know if you want to fuck with Mad Dog,
hell
man.
No.
Mad Dog was something else when he was acting duty.
Man, I don't give a fuck.
Mad Dog was the only range I know that wasn't airborne.
Oh, he was airborne. He had airborne wings.
That was a foot soldier.
He had airborne wings, though.
That nigga always said he wasn't airborne.
He had airborne wings. Mad Dog had airborne wings.
He must have went over there and said, hey, give me my shit, motherfucker.
I've done my best.
These motherfuckers ain't going to ever let me fucking lay this shit down. Mad Dog, look, I love you for that shit, bro.
Hey, man.
These niggas ain't going to let me live it down.
Matt, I tell you, the first time I met Matt, actually talked to Mad Dog, it was after the change of command ceremony. I was going through the company area, and I was at the supply. Well, I was going towards the arm room and supply room, and Mad Dog was like, hey, give me that bone. So I was like, yes, First Sergeant, you know, young little PV2 private and shit.
Hey, why are you still a PV2?
I just got here, First Sergeant.
Oh, I thought you fucked up.
Hey, on that note, so I'm gonna talk about something. So one night I was in the room, me and Cruz was roommates, and we brought these two chicks from Marcy Projects to the barracks. I'm skinning one up. We had a little curtain across the room. I'm skinning one up, bah, bah, bah. He's skinning one up on the other side, bah, bah, bah. And this little punk motherfucker, named Hallucci decides he wants to come through the bathroom.
Fucking Hallucci.
And talk shit. Oh,
my
shit. God.
That was my boy. You know that,
and
right?
Talk shit about
motherfucking yeah, I'm the one who brought him
not
over
opening
here.
The door to let him use my microwave. So, you know, I'm busting some skins. I said, man, get the fuck up out of the room. Man, fuck you, nigga.
I remember that shit, man, because Hallucci came crying to me. She was like,
"So listen, what I'm saying."
He called you a nigga.
Yeah, Cruz say, "No, James, no, don't worry about it."
Yo,
I said,
Hallucci
okay,
didn't
cool.
say that.
So,
that's when that nigga started pushing the broom.
yeah. So, hold on, no, oh, Josiah, Cruz kept me from jumping on his ass at that time. Oh, so I said, you know what, I'm gonna go around and talk to him. And so after I bust my little. Yeah. So I get up, you know, I put some shorts on, I walk around, I slide on around there. And Mo was standing in the hallway. He said, man, what's up? I said, man, this man called me the N-word. I'm going to talk to him. And Mo was like, hi, you know, whoa. So I'm talking to this man. This man called me the N-word again. Mo said, no. I gave his ass the business. He busted his nose up, gave him a black eye. So his bitch ass went up to staff duty.
Yeah, I remember that shit.
Staff duty called the MPs. Sergeant Quinto, who was my squad leader, I mean team leader, was at the door when staff duty came, when the MPs came. And he was like, hey, I got MPs. He's like, no. Staff duty called me, and the staff duty punk ass, who also got in trouble because he called the MPs instead of calling the sergeant major.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So when Fact. The MPs came and got me, they took me down, handcuffs and everything. San Quinto said, I'm going to come get you. San Quinto was drunk than a motherfucker.
Hey, let me tell you about Quinto real quick, man.
Drunk.
I got so high at goddamn Quinto house one time, man, in the housing area right there. Before you, right across, if you go into the main PX,
yep.
If you was going to the main PX, you make a right and go into the housing area. I got so goddamn high, man, I couldn't even find my goddamn way back to the barracks.
Bruh. So...
Quinto had that good herb.
So Quinto comes up there and get me. So in person, old Chuck comes get Hallucci.
No, Chuck was Miller.
Yes.
Person was Gerald.
Miller came and get Hallucci, and Quinto came and got me. Quinto was drunk the hell. I don't know why he come and get me. I don't know how he came and got me, but he came and got me. And Sorry, Chuck say, I say, what's up, Sorry? He say, is your wrist hurting? I said, no. He said, that was a good motherfucking hit. Man, when I saw Hallucci, I was like, oh, shit. Nose still bleeding.
Broke that shit, matter of fact.
I like this. I is like this. That was punk ass get. That's what I said. So, boom. This is how I met in GT. First sergeant didn't want to give me an ARC 15.
Who the hell trying to get in my goddamn room?
Nigga, that window might get in your damn room. They was across the hall.
Oh,
nigga.
Okay. I'm just making sure.
First sergeant didn't want to give me an ARC 15, but I came down on the blotter.
I'm going to tell the cameraman, get the gat.
Get the gat, motherfucker.
Y'all don't want to fuck. Let me tell you, hold on. Wait. Before we finish, y'all don't want to fuck with these motherfuckers. Like, y'all may sit here and look at me because, you know, I'm doing the podcast. I'm the fucking face and all this shit. These motherfuckers here, like, I don't have to carry. When I do, trust me, I do. But even if you get me, I promise you, these motherfuckers are coming behind me. They gonna know who the fuck you are because they know everything I do.
187 on a motherfucking ass.
See that shit? This shit is fucking synchronized, nigga. It ain't nothing with it.
But fuck that. But like I said, so I get my Article 15, and boom, I report. I get off at 1700. I report at 1800. Because, you know, you get that hour to do chow.
Lunch. I mean, dinner.
So, I report, and it's a new NCO. I said, hey, Sean, I'm here, you know, I'm important for a staff dude. He said, oh, you the one that broke the dude's nose and gave him a black eye. Fuck you, too.
Yeah, matter of fact, GT was fucking...
He had just got
Hallucci's team leader.
Yep.
He was my team leader, too.
So... You know, all that to say, I did my extra duty. Now, forward a couple of years ago, Hallucci sends me a friend request.
You accepted
it? I accepted it. I goes into his inbox and I say, hey, bro, hey, what happened when we, you know, was in the military? That was me as a young, you know, woo.
We grown. We grown.
Inbox me back and say, nigga, fuck you. When I see you, I'm going to kill you.
Are you serious? But you know, when that shit happened, I told you and I told his ass. His little fucking ass deserved that shit.
All right, so let me give y'all a little background about this nigga. So I met Hallucci from coming from not even MEPS. Like, I met Hallucci on the bus going to New Jersey before we went to down to Benning.
He was from New England.
And he's from New Jersey.
Jersey, New England, it's all the same.
So we went down there, and this motherfucker been a hair since day one, because we went down there and some bitch was about to give me some ass. And I was like, yo, you got to be the fucking wingman. And I was like, I'm going to fuck about the other bitch. I was like, and so this do you know what this motherfucker did to me?
Wingman, I should punch his ass in the mouth.
And the bitch wasn't even ugly. The friend wasn't ugly at all.
That's what I'm saying. I should punch your ass.
But this was, nigga, this was like coming down to Fort Benning. This wasn't even like nothing. I had an ugly bitch.
He's pretty passionate about that.
I had an ugly bitch.
We had to fucking join. This motherfucker, only reason why he got mad is because he wasn't getting no fucking pussy. Right? He wasn't getting no fucking ass. So this motherfucker went in the fucking hallway of the hotel where everybody was going down to basic training. We was like disbursement area. These bitches. This motherfucker took the goddamn fire extinguisher. Sprayed the shit in the fucking hallway.
Sprayed it.
The fire alarm went off. And I was fire this close. Alarm went off. Bruh, I had sent the friend to my room.
Friend to his room.
I went to their room.
He went to their room.
Nigga, listen. So and that's how I started with that. He went to Lurch. What was that on drum?
Lurch.
So he went to Lurch, and I came to drum as, a foot soldier.
Yeah.
And so.
We was the best in it.
Oh, man, we was the best. Was it, nigga.
But you know, them niggas from Lurse came to 287.
Exactly.
NG, Hallucci.
Hold on, before we get done, I got to say this one story about NG. Man, we was doing a PT test. NG came from Lurse to us because of First Sergeant Mattis.
Yeah.
And we did a PT test, and we took off.
That motherfucker got to the goddamn halfway point at goddamn 5 minutes.
I'm running. I'm like, who the fuck is this in front of me?
That motherfucker could run. This motherfucker.
He got to the turnaround point.
That nigga hit that wall.
Hey. This nigga lit up a cigarette.
Hey, man.
Hit it three times.
I ain't gonna
put it
fucking
out.
Lie to you, bro.
I turned around and took off running. This nigga shot past me like I was standing fucking still.
You talking about GT?
NG. Roberto NG. Shout out to this motherfucker, man.
You know that's a Philly nigga right there. What's up, NG?
This motherfucker, man.
This nigga.
That motherfucker ran down to the halfway point on the 2 mile run within five motherfucking minutes. And was waiting on motherfuckers to get to the halfway point. Cheering us on and shit.
Let's go.
That motherfucker ran back down to the goddamn finish line within goddamn 10 minutes, bro. And he.
No, I
that nigga was like 9:50. 8 or 57
was crazy. NG was sprinting the whole shit.
Run, bro. Mouth full of goddamn gold teeth. Panamanian cat.
What's going on, NG?
Glass was my man because Glass saved my oldest son from drowning. When we was on Family Day.
I can give him.
Vaughn jumped his ass in the pool. Me and Roxanne in the room. Vaughn jumped his ass in the pool. Didn't know how to swim. Glass was out there. Glass saved him. So Glass was my number one dude.
Right. I remember that.
He was my number one dude. When me and this man right here.
After y'all was about to box.
Yeah, after we was about to bang. But found out we was from South Carolina together.
But
our bond came so goddamn tight.
Like I was saying earlier, I don't know if we got this on air or whatnot, but I read Pimp when I was goddamn 13 years old.
This nigga still on his reading Pimp.
Hey, nigga. This shit worked for me.
Hey, I ain't the fake Bill Cosby. Hey, nigga.
But let me tell you one goddamn thing. No, we could get that.
We gotta be over there in like less than an hour.
Oh,
okay.
Shit.
We have to be over there in less than an hour.
And plus, Mickey Howard, she comes on tonight. Yeah. So I gotta hear love on the new management.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. So listen.
I love goddamn Mickey Howard. All right.
So listen, real quick, before we get the fuck out of here, because I mean we. We all drunk and shit. We about to go do some other things.
You knew what was gonna happen.
Hey man, this shit, man. Jones, Khalid,
Fuck Khalil.
Hey, Khalil.
Oh.
Hey,
what,
bro.
What, West Philly?
Hey. North, nigga. That ain't no fucking West. Hey. North, nigga.
Hey, man. Oh. Putting this shit together right here, man. North having Philly. Having us come together to do this shit, man. This shit right here is like.
Fuck North.
Nah,
Philly.
Nah, we ain't gonna do no.
Nah, we ain't gonna fuck no
fucking
nobody.
No, he's just being stupid.
He just being a dickhead right now.
Fuck North.
And that's why I hate this motherfucker. All
right. But anyway.
Oh, that's why that nigga turned 90, bringing this shit together right here, man,
and for us to tell our stories, man, and educate and all that good shit, man. This right here, man, is what it's all about. We got our cameraman. He was sitting here, cool as shit.
And this motherfucker ain't but 22. He's
22 years old, man. Came from Wisconsin, man.
Wisconsin. He's a Green Bay
All the way down to goddamn Atlanta. He don't know nobody down here, but he want to make it. You know what I mean?
He's a cheesehead, y'all.
And one of the people that he actually linked up with, man, is one of the people that we care and cherish with all of our fucking hearts, man. And that's Kat. That's Catherine.
Kathy, baby.
You know what I mean? And I can tell you, man, from the first time I met Kat, I can remember, I was like, I know you, but I don't know you. And that was just the vibe that me and Kat put off, man. Mm-hmm. And then Chia and Kriya, yeah, me and Chia, we got a fucking vibe. You know what I mean? Like, every time me and Chia link up, we fucking vibing, bro. And it's the same way with fucking Kat. Like, in 2021, Kat had her 60th birthday at Grown Folks Cafe on Old National Highway in Atlanta. And I think
we about to bring Kat to the live.
I got to the venue, and Kat told me, Mahoney, we got Kat live.
Yo, put the speaker up to the mic.
You know I'm in Atlanta, right?
How you know?
Because Khalil told me you was coming up.
You was a sapsucker.
All right, Kat. This Mo. We giving you flowers now, all right?
We giving you your flowers on the podcast.
All right.
Give me my flowers.
Yes, ma'am.
I can't come.
Hey, don't worry about it. We're going to see you tomorrow. We're going to see you tomorrow.
We're going to pull up on your ass. All
right.
Okay.
2021.
2021.
Kat having her birthday party at Grown Folks Cafe on Old National. I got the invite from Khalil, and I showed up, and Kat said, Mahoney, you gonna fucking party tonight. And believe me, I motherfucking party, man.
Ain't that the truth?
Yes, ma'am.
Party without hey,
Kat, but you know you ain't goddamn spirit with us, man. And every time I come to Atlanta, I came to Atlanta for Chia and Kriya's birthday on Memorial Day weekend. And I had a fucking ball, man, at Monticello's, and we're gonna do it again tonight. Even though you can't make it, but we're gonna kick it off with my boy Skillet. We're gonna do it big. We're gonna do it big, man.
First of all, I missed it, but I was up here that Sunday. And we had a good time that Sunday. But hey, you know what today is, right?
Today is your birthday, Irby.
Yeah.
Oh, happy birthday, nigga. I'm mad. Y'all know I'm heated that I can't come today.
I know, cause you know how we.
When you leaving,
Irby? I gotta come by and see you before I leave out, cause my daughter just moved to Decatur, so you know I'm gonna get her address tomorrow. But we gonna swing by to see you tomorrow, and then I'm gonna go stop by her house and see my daughter.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
All right. Looking forward to y'all. Call me when y'all get up, cause you know you are gonna party tonight. The number one partier with you, Shea.
Yeah, man.
She ain't gonna stay in that smoke room. I'm gonna tell you that right now. Okay.
Hey, you know how it was when I came here in Memorial Day weekend for her birthday and her sister's birthday.
Right.
You know how we did
it.
You know how we did it, Kat. We closed this motherfucker down.
Early, okay.
We closed that bitch down, bruh. Hey,
right.
okay, Khalil was like, where Mahoney? Shit, Mahoney good.
No, I was fucking scared. Like, where the fuck is this nigga? He said he don't know where the fuck he at in the club. Where is, find him.
He didn't give a fuck. That's what he He was having such a good time. He's like, I don't give a fuck where I am right now. Shit, I'm going to get back to the hotel. And he did.
Yeah, hey, man.
Y'all about to do the shit again tonight.
Hey, yes, we are. Hey, but hey, I just want to give a shout out to you. But the cameraman is my guy.
Oh, yeah, that's my nigga, boy. That's my nigga. Okay,
hey.
We
told him about some stories, you know what I'm saying, back in the day. He just sitting here laughing at us like, y'all niggas was out of control.
You didn't tell him how you met me, did you?
No, I ain't.
No, we ain't going into them stories,
man. We ain't going. We don't want to mess his head up.
Yeah, he good people. When I tell you, he the best that I've seen in a long time as far as personality and who he is, and he really true to what he say he gonna do.
Hey, He just threw up the heart sign.
Right. He meeting y'all out tonight?
Oh yeah, he rolling with us.
So Glass was in the gym talking to Sedera, and I say, hey bro, Cat just pulled up. Man, all right, bro. So I'm playing, cause you know we always went to the gym and play. Me and Glass always went to the gym and play.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So yeah. I'm playing. She walk in and I literally got the ball and I just threw up a shot and ran back. And as I'm running back, I'm like, this nigga ain't paying me no attention. Boom, Cat, V-line. She caught straight across the court to this nigga. She about to beat Sedera ass. Glass like, oh, yeah. So now Glass trying to blame. This one, me and Glass fell out.
Mm-hmm.
He trying to blame me for everything. I'm like, nigga, I was telling you she outside, nigga. I told your dumb ass. But no, on some real shit, though.
But Cat good people, though.
So
man.
Just to let y'all know, this motherfucker knows Cat intimately. He Cat records for her. He records her fucking her modeling shit.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Cat's some good fucking people, man.
Just know when you see Cat, say, Cat, what's up with Irby?
You gonna see the joy on her face. Real rap. The joy on her face when you say that shit.
I'm gonna tell you a story about Cat, man. When you're doing your editing, put some of the shit in here, man, because some of the shit is fucking some good shit. But when we giving Cat and Kriya and Chia their flowers, you know what I'm saying? Look. Put that shit in there because that shit.